Hey guys. Here we are back on Wind Chaser. We went ahead and bought Field 26, finally. Been really itching to get over here and buy this and spruce it up. We also, in that last video, you saw that we bought this new spraying setup. So we're just, you can see the nutrients there in the little window, pretty low. So we're just doing some pre-plow spray, and then we'll bring one of the bigger tractors over here and plow up some headlands and get a nice border for course play. So this field was 446,000. We had to take out a loan actually to pay for it. I took out a $80,000 loan to help pay for it, and I'm not really sure how far we're gonna go. How far we're gonna expand this field, but. Just spray it around here just in case I feel like expanding the field out this far. This will be a great field once it's all plowed up and developed a little bit. Might as well plow up this little road, this path as well, because it's really serves no purpose. So we're able to spray faster and longer with these tanks and this pole type sprayer as compared to the self-propelled. Now that I have that done, I'm actually going to go ahead and use. Nine R. Oh shoot. Never mind. We'll just go ahead and use the cat. Forgot to fill this up. I guess you guys get to see a little kitty cat in action. It looks amazing. So we'll just go ahead and run this on manual a little bit. And then once we get course play set up, we can finish up our spraying. Come in with the planter and plant that quick, because we have 2 days till the growth stage changes. It'll be a little bit easier to manage this on the GPS than that 41 meter working with. So I'm up pretty early. It's about 4:30 in the morning. I'm taking the train, the Amtrak train to New York for the 4th of July to the girlfriend's place. My train leaves at 6:15. It's only about a 15-minute walk from my apartment, so it's not that big of a deal. So it takes me all the way to Stamford, Connecticut. This will improve the view and our overall bottom line with our crops. Probably could have. trying to grab as much land as practically possible here. With a nice clean edge. Because this road is completely pointless, really. curious to see how big this field actually is. Meanwhile, we're going to go ahead and catch up on our spring. So this will be a very nice field to harvest now. Has some weeds in it, has a little bit of corn residue to till in. Nice change of scenery. Course play friendly. Thank you. So, we're up to 279.79. Equals about 691 acres. We're farming now 692 acres. So, not a bad amount of acreage to be farming. I have a feeling we're gonna tack on several more acres. After we sell our soybeans and after this upcoming harvest, which this field should be included. I think it's time to make a new pole type sprayer. Because this one just doesn't really fit in. Capacity of this rig is impressive, as is the rate that we can spray. It really kind of blows the self-propelled unit out of the water for productivity. This is going to be nice to get rid of some of this chopped straw residue, as this was transferred over from FS13 on this map. So this chopped straw, I've never farmed this at all in 15, so this is all 13 terrain and chopped straw. So pretty crazy to think about, really. Twenty-five right there on the other side. That would also be a nice field. This 27-28 deal. I'm not too sure. It should really be two fields. sure the DB120 planner will love that. Some areas need to be smoothed out over here. So just some few minor terrain issues. Well, it's nice that we can do the capacity of these tanks are 1,200 gallons, so it was like 4,000 some liters. So basically what we have left is the saddle tanks. Otherwise we would be just about empty right now, I think. So it's nice to have those tanks, kind of adds about 40%. Switch to our saddle tank, so says they're about 96%. I think our sprayer is completely empty. We're running all on the saddle nurse tanks here. Meanwhile, the kitty cat keeps killing it on the 2720. That's pretty impressive. We only had to take about 10% of our saddle tanks to do this field. In the other tractor and help this guy out. Speck of dirt showing up on the tanks. Freshly planted fields. This is kind of our smaller 8R shed, implement shed. So until we have to go and spray again, just have our DN and our 2100. Now this. Spray trailer way in the back there for whatever reason.
I don't know why I parked it back there.
Just pull the truck out and swap it for something else. So. I don't really need to fill this all the way up. Much everywhere we look, we kind of own the field now, at least in this southern part. So you can see back behind that, own that field, all this. Don't own this field on the hill that belongs to this dairy farm. And 27, 28, and 25 will be the next to go. make sure I'm running the same course as the other tractor. Get to I really appreciate all the trees I had to put in here. It's literally thousands of trees, so. It's a pretty fair distance across this field. I think this is the longest, one of the longer stretches. This is the one next to me.